Evening folks, this is Best in Slot, back with another episode of our Planet Zoo franchise build. Now we're going to kick things off today already a little bit in and already with the time lapse. I do apologise for that, I've had some pretty weird issues with my recording lately. It keeps stopping and I cannot figure out why. It's almost like there's a hotkey I'm using for Planet Zoo that stops my recording somehow. So I apologise for that, it's going to happen again later on, but we do have a solid 2 hours or so of time-lapse footage here, cut down with 7x speed into about 17 minutes or so, and then we've got a solid 10 minutes of more building and taking a look and talking about the future, so we should get a look at the exhibit properly. Now this is going to be our pronghorn antelope exhibit, our second North American animal before we move on to something in the next video. We've still got the wolves to go and something else I keep forgetting. So I really wanted to do something different with this, and I had this idea that I've been messing around with all day long before I finally settled on this build. I went back and forth constantly on what I was going to do here, absolutely constantly, and I really wanted to do something with this exhibit that was a little bit more special, something a little bit more impressive, something that stood out, something that wasn't just a field. And at a very early stage I got into my head the idea of like a slightly tiered exhibit in terms of how the ground is laid out. You can see there it's in multiple different steps, again apologies that recording didn't survive, and then having it curve at the back and then having something there that was part of the curve. And I wasn't really sure for a long time what it was going to be. I knew I wanted it to be glass, I knew I wanted it to be modern, but I really didn't know what that was going to look like until we landed on this, these weird things, these glass pillars. Now I've got another idea for how we're going to use these outside of the exhibit, and we're going to do that. It's going to be a bit of a theme of the pronghorn area in general, but what I'm doing here is just using these glass rectangles made like a little bit of a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, an octagon by the looks of things. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, made some octagon pillars and we're going to use those to create a sort of background to the exhibit essentially, and it ends up looking pretty cool. I'll say that much, I actually end up really happy with how this whole area looks. About half of this is going to be spent on the exhibit and about half of this on the viewing areas and surrounding bits and stuff like that. Still a little bit of work to do, but some stuff that I'm going to want suggestions from you folks at home, so feel free again to leave some comments about that when we get there. Now the idea initially behind this was kind of for it to be kind of to look like a mountain, kind of it to look like rock but made out of modern glass. I think to an extent it sort of ends up looking more like a city, but that's okay, that's pretty cool as well. And all things are pretty cool. Everything is cool. The point is it looks good, and that's what matters. It's kind of like a little bit of a centerpiece after the bison was relatively tame. And I really want to, especially in this zoo where we're trying to bring in the mix of modern and sort of natural. Yes, natural, let's get it out of the way nice and early. I think it's important to mess around with this kind of thing, and this is something I want to do again and again and again and again and again. Not this exactly, but you know, this rough idea. I do think it's going to look a little odd for most of this video, but you get up close like that and it looks really cool. I really, really like how it looks. It's this slightly modern art-esque look to it. Unfortunately, there's a little issue with the viewing distance in that it doesn't... Oh yeah, I'm going to put in like loads of shop there, like the little keeper area here, and end up getting rid of it entirely. So this bit's all a waste, so I can talk nonsense for a little bit. The viewing distance in this game doesn't appear to be changeable via the options. At least I couldn't change it via the options. I don't really know why. And the glass... Should have worked. The glass is kind of... Every bloody video. The glass is kind of more opaque. The closer you get to it, it looks a little bit better. From a distance, it fades out a little bit. And there's no real way I've found of changing that, unfortunately. So we're going to have to deal with that. We're going to get some pronghorns in. We're going to put those in pretty early. Just checking here how many pronghorns we can have. Found an albino as well for relatively cheap. So thought we'd grab that. I'm fortunately moderately loaded. Although I've very much been neglecting my breeding zoo lately. People do keep asking me, how do I have so many CC points? I know people with lots more, I really haven't touched it in a while. I simply have a breeding zoo where I breed animals and then sell them, basically. That's it. It really isn't that hard to make CC, and it isn't market dependent, because what I will do is tend to release animals to the wild rather than selling them on the actual market. So, you know, it's something anyone can do with very little, with very much ease. Anyways, we got our first pronghorn in, and this was the first issue. Of course, there was going to be problems in terms of escaping from the side, so we're going to edit that. And also, I want the pronghorns to... I don't really think of pronghorns as living necessarily in a hilly environment, so I didn't want it to be over the top. And I wanted to have like this nice flat area at the bottom that's more like the fields they may typically live in. But they do live in some areas that would have elevation like this, so I thought it was okay, but I wanted to make sure it was easy for them to get up those multiple tiers. Just adding a little bit of glass at the side. To the side, I hate how that looks. We're going to use that again just to block off that side a little bit. But mainly here we're messing around with the barrier in an attempt to control the animals somewhat. I really should never have gotten rid of the one on the side. I had like a glass pillar kept off to the side that I could keep using, and I figured I was done with it, and then I had to make it again and again and again and again. So just bringing them down, really trying to make it sort of like fairly a gradual drop. So again, it kind of has a natural look to it, even though it's made of this, you know, incredibly modern material. I do want to do some more stuff with this. I'm thinking vines or cracks in it or something like that, but I don't know. I think it should stand as like a modern art piece that happens to be the back of an exhibit. I think that's the goal for it. But there's lots of other cool stuff we're going to do as well. Bring in a little bit of water down here at the bottom. I did start to have some weird camera issues right about now. and that the camera was moving super slowly. So I think I end up stopping relatively soon, and then we're going to skip forward. Now, I am going to put tons of foliage in this exhibit. Unfortunately, the recording stopped. I really didn't realize at the time for about 40 minutes of putting foliage down, so that is all going to skip forward. I do apologize. You're obviously going to get a good look at that at the end of the video and even further on into the time lapse, but it does mean all the foliage stuff basically got annihilated. I don't know what's going on. I'm going to have to figure out what the problem is, because it's driving me moderately insane, and I'm already moderately insane, so you put that together and yeah, we're living in dangerous times. I've got to imagine the jump is fairly soon. Spent a long time trying to figure out what we're going to do for the viewing area here. It's not that complicated. It is, at the end of the day, just a bridge with a shelter, but it's about the details around it that make it come to life for me, and it ends up looking pretty cool. I really wanted to get some more elevation. I think in general, there you go. There's the skip forward. I am sorry about that. We caught a little bit of it, putting some rocks down for a little rock bridge, stuff like that. Just pretending there's a nice way for the antelope to get up to the top of the exhibit if they so choose. You're going to see all the rocks, which is nice. You know, rocks are cool. And then we're going to zoom out a little bit as well. But the foliage really helps with the exhibit, I think. It makes the glass wall appear less impactful, but in a good way, because the trees are kind of blocking off some of those sight lines. The trees are adding some more elevation that wasn't there previously. It makes the whole thing come together a little bit more. Putting in some random little features here, a little rock pile that's fallen down a little bit into the little lake we have there. And some moss. I really liked this idea. I've never done this before, but I'm putting all the carpet moss in, but we're only putting it, I put it there, I'm going to get rid of that in a second. We're going to only put it on the bits of the rock that face the sunlight, because that's how moss grows, right? That's how you can actually tell. I can't remember the actual ruling on how it works, but basically you can tell which way the sun will rise, because that's the side of the tree that the moss is on, or something like that. Either way. Yeah, it's cool. That's basically our viewing area right there. And a little bit you can walk down the side, you can walk between the bison and the antelope, and you've got little glass windows there as well. But yeah, the viewing area, nothing too complex, but it ends up looking pretty cool. And that's really where most of the work is going to go right now. The exhibit itself is basically done at this point. So we're going to block all this off in some lovely jubbly wood. Who doesn't love a little bit of wood? Nerds, that's a little bit of a wall on there as well. That's going to block people off. Just stop people jumping into the viewing area and hugging an antelope or riding an antelope, as the case may be. You know, would not surprise me that much at all. And really, this is basically similar to what we did with the bison. We're just trying to make a nice modern looking area that still has some of those Native American influences, which is really the basis of our entire park. We're bringing back the pillars. We use these right at the start of the zoo. And again, this is something I want to do. I want to use consistent materials, consistent architectural styles throughout the whole thing. You know, this roof is going to look quite a lot like the roof we used in the entrance to the zoo. But then you've got the big glass wall, and that's a little bit different. Or you've got something else that's a little bit different. It's about having a consistent theme, but one that then you can add extra touches to make each individual area feel unique. That's a thing I really like in design in general, so that's really something we want to try to focus on throughout this entire playthrough. How much of a nerd do I sound when I say stuff like that? I'm actually really into, like, interior design and all this kind of stuff, oddly enough. Not something I've ever really realised. Did attempt to mix this up a little bit, but yeah, just wasn't really sure how to make this particularly interesting. We do end up doing some stuff with this to brighten up a little bit more in a moment, but for now, just adding the pillars. Annoyingly, they don't quite, you see it there, doesn't quite fit, so it has to go into the path and all the others go into the wall. It's moderate, it's very slightly annoying, but I'm gonna force myself to get over it slightly. And yeah, just messing around the pattern. I was gonna go for this checkerboard thing, decided to, no, not interested in that. again, it's that mix of patterns. And here it's about adding the angle again. You know, just that slightly symmetrical look to it. And we're going to put another one at the other side. Again, screwed around with doing a little bit more. Decide this is a terrible idea. And he's like, there we go. And decide we need something on the other side as well, like so. So one side goes up, one side goes down, and that creates this symmetry while still looking realistic, while still looking like a shelter, and it just makes it fit in architecturally with the rest of the park as well. Same as using these little things here. Again, it's about the modern with those natural touches, at least somewhat. And again, you know, again, consistent theme. We're going to use these bushes as kind of like a little bit of a banner, kind of a little bit of a border edge around the wood. We don't go as crazy this time. It's a little bit more limited. I kept it to the outside rather than going on the inside. You know, it doesn't go round to... Okay, it does there. A little bit. But generally speaking, it's not going to be round on this side. It's going to be mainly on the other side. Just to... You know, it's more of a feature of the bison exhibit, basically. There's no flowers in there yet, although I might add some now that I've just remembered. That's a thing. I did kind of forget. And again, as with the opening area, as in the bridge area, we're just going to line this with a little bit of white. Not too much. I'm not going to do the whole thing, but just the front edges. And you do get to see it at nighttime, and the whole thing looks really cool. I'm super happy with how this zoo is working out. I really enjoyed My Pen Rai, our Asian zoo, I will say, but I think I enjoy this kind of thing a little bit more. This kind of, yeah, this was a massive pain in the ass, by the way, trying to move this thing over. I think I enjoy this a little bit more. I really liked My Pen Rai, it was really good fun, lots of foliage stuff, but messing around with building and trying to do consistent themes and trying to build buildings and make it look really cool at night and all light. I love lights, you know? Anytime the game lets me mess around with lights, I'm going to be happy. And My Pen Rai was quite difficult towards the end, I'd say, to come up with new ways to view each exhibit, to make each exhibit different, because at the end of the day, it's a natural environment. There's only so many natural features you can really do in a rainforest. Whereas here, we can do anything. We can go utterly bloody mental. We really can. There's nothing stopping us. This whole area does need... There's going to be a lot more wood. Let's put it that way. There's going to be a hell of a lot more wood. I'm going to block off that whole area on the right, basically turn it into a little staff area. Here we're just kind of messing around with the wall a little bit, just trying to make it more of a consistent, long glass block. Nice, just a nicer looking viewing area at the end of the day. Move that around as well, make the staff area blend in a little bit more. And that eventually means we can hide these walls entirely as well. The more null barrier you can have, the better, right? Surely. So there you go. Null barrier, looking very null. And a little bit of a metal ring around there, just to... designate that as a staff area. You know, it's got the metal, it's a little bit more serious than the big bushy bit. As much as I love a big bushy bit, who doesn't? And here we're just going to line this with a little bit of wood. It is basically two different construction builds, so they don't actually fit together that well. And I used the wrong one here. This was a mistake on my part right here. So the construction build is a little bit finicky, but honestly, if you're willing to disentangle the... building bits from the group, you can make everything come together in the end. It just takes a little bit of finagling, which is a great word, by the way. It's a proper word. I don't think I made finagling up, but I wonder if it's in the dictionary. I'm very curious about that. I'll have to see. So it's a little bit more closed in than the bison. You know, there's not this big... At the end of the day, the ghost of Blackrock was this big deal for the zoo, right? It was meant to be this big, important thing. So the... antelope doesn't quite have that. It does have something pretty cool that we're going to see in a minute, though, hopefully. Let's just bring the donation boxes in. Very exciting. Hopefully I can get this video done before the football starts. So I wanted to fill this gap in. I really wanted to use the statue because we've got this really nice pronghorn statue, right? It would be silly not to use it. But I didn't want it to look too much like the Ghost of Blackrock. So the Ghost of Blackrock sign has him standing on a rock. This is standing on a rock. It's already very similar. So there's no mist, there's no signage. It's kind of not drawn attention to in the same way. It's there to show off, and you know, we've got this fancy pronghorn sign, right? I want to show it off, but I did want it to feel demonstrably different from the Ghost of Blackrock. And fill this area in, basically just make this area look pretty nice. But this is how we're going to integrate the glass tubing any second now. Yeah, we're going to grab that. I'm going to move a couple of those in there, just so there's a bit of a thematic link between both sections. And we'll talk about this. So my plan, I've been doing so much Googling of glass sculptures and stuff like that, just to find inspiration for the park. I've got so many different things I want to build, like modern art sculptures and different shapes I want to bring into different exhibits that we're going to do in the future. But one really cool thing I saw was from, I can't remember where it was, but it was some building. And I decided not to use this here, by the way. I'm going to have to come up with a different way of integrating those. I think that's a little bit... Wait, do I use them? No, I got rid of them. One thing that was really cool that I saw was you kind of walk along this corridor. One side is closed off. I think we'll do like a water wall there. Like, you know, be like our water walls again. That's a theme of the park a little bit. But the other side, they had all these like really thick trees, and each tree was encased in like this, basically these glass tubes that look just like this. So I think we can do the same thing. We might have to make slightly smaller ones, maybe make them into, maybe even the squares. Can I think of any other way to do it? Well, I'll think of something. maybe squares, maybe diamonds or something like that. Maybe like a diamond shape, maybe like a rhombus, whatever. The point is we can do that and then have the trees within these glass tubes, and we can have like a line that you walk along. So you walk down this open pathway. On the right, there's a water wall. On the left, there's all these glass tubes with the trees inside them. And that should make the whole area kind of flow a little bit nicer, because, you know, I really like how they look, but it is a very standout feature that has to feel integrated into the rest of the park, or this area of the park, at least a little bit. So I think in the next area, when we're leading this pronghorn antelope path back towards the start of the zoo, we're going to bring in some of those glass tubes filled with trees and make it a little bit of a feature in and of itself. That's the plan anyway. So, putting some reeds in, decided to rotate the reeds. I realised why I don't like the reeds is because they automatically tilt unless you you can change it so it doesn't do that, but I've always got the option on so it tilts, and I think that ruins it a little bit. I think turning off the tilt actually makes a big difference. We're going to add some lights. We're actually near the end now, only a minute and a half left or so. Like I said, the area is definitely less built up, I would say, than the bison one, but I think it looks pretty cool. Bringing in these nettles actually really helps, because you can see the path is not quite even, the whole thing's a little bit not symmetrical, but bringing in the nettles very much gives it the appearance of symmetry, which is what we're looking for. I very much like it, and here's me taking screenshots for the thumbnail. I'm going to mess around with my thumbnail style just a little bit. I realise that the way I do thumbnails is really bad at showcasing architecture or exhibits and stuff like that, because I put this big photo of the animal right front and center near enough, or to the right hand side, and hide the logo, which I really like, but I will say it doesn't suit when you do an exhibit like this. You can't really show it off in the thumbnail without changing things up. Here I'm buying some tigers for CC and then selling them instantly, so I have some money because I'm poor. Basically, but I will say the zoo officially makes money. We'll see that a little later on. I was just trying to come up with something here, just something to make the area. Again, the bison area's got all these interesting little things. I wanted something here. I've still not quite grasped it. You know, we're going to end things here. Doing a little bit of a pattern with these. It ends up looking okay, but it needs something else. I'm considering replacing this top wooden wall with a metal clad wall instead. I think that might look pretty cool. But other than that, we are done. So, we'll be hopping back in a second. You're going to get 10 minutes or so of gameplay, and we're going to see the park at night. It looks really cool. We're going to add more lights in. We're going to hang around with all the pronghorns when they're in. So you're going to see a lot of good stuff. And then next video, I think we're going to build a shopping area. And then I think we're going to do the science museum. I'm not sure. And then after that, we've got two more habitat animals, which is the wolves and something else. And I keep forgetting what that something else is. And off the top of my head, I honestly couldn't tell you. Is it the grizzly bear? It's the grizzly bear. Of course it is. So we'll do the grizzly bear as well. Right. So I will see you in a second. Okay, folks, that's where we are going to end it for now. There's a few little things that need changing. I've been racking my brain. This area in general over here on the right-hand side, I think we need to maybe make these doorways a little bit less, you know, holes in the wall and more look like doorways. I'm not convinced about this little hexagon pattern going on here. And I need something over here. Now, you're going to walk down here because you're going to want to just... We're going to keep this fairly simple. You're going to walk down here. You're going to look at the pronghorn. You're going to look over here to the bison. It's really nice having this middle viewing area. But there's this sort of dead area at the end, and I'm not really sure what we're going to put there. I'm thinking of doing like a little conservation education board sort of thing, using the conservation items and kind of making like a environmental display and putting it in there, and just, you know, because that kind of ties in with a lot of the themes of the park as well. This area is obviously a little bit simpler, I would say, than the bison one, but you know, the exhibit itself is much more complex, and this area is, I actually quite like this little viewing area and this little bit down here. It's all kind of themed together. Now, I will say, again, I haven't recorded the time lapse yet, so there's probably about 10 billion things I'm going to say that I've already said, but bear with me. These might seem a little out of place. I actually really like how it looks, but I think once we get these lit up at night, that's going to be amazing. But also, I've got a little bit of an idea about how we can also use these glass tubes in a little bit. We're going to have, when you come out of this side of the exhibit, I'm going to drop down. The idea is to link this with this over here, probably with a shopping area in this gap here. I did actually try to do that before this video and I just couldn't. For some reason, I couldn't get it to work. So I'm thinking you're going to come out and you're going to go right and you're going to walk down this nice area here, shops on the right, and then that'll link in with the main area here, and this will tie the whole thing together. So shops and the thing. Now, I'm not going to tell you what the plan is, but I do have a pretty cool idea, I think, about how we can use these tubes just a little bit more. Not too much. I don't want it to be a feature of the entire park, but I do want it to be a somewhat feature of the area. And I've got what I think is a pretty cool plan, but we'll have to see and wait if it works or not. Other than that, I'm pretty happy with the whole thing. Maybe a little sprucing up here and there, like I said, a staff area there and whatever we're going to do over here. But I love to get a little bit of feedback and some ideas from you lovely folks at home. So that's why we'll hold off on this. Feel free to let me know what you think we should do in this gap and how we could bring the area to life just a little bit more. But generally speaking, yeah, pretty happy. Right, let's make sure our Pronghorns are happy as well. I still think we're not making any money. Keeper work zone does not include. What? Oh, have I given you the wrong? I know what the problem is. Pronghorns. Work zone. 3 buildings, 1 staff room, no habitat. I am the big dumb. There we go. right, that should be fine. Oh, we got a new baby bison. A new bison are popping up everywhere, actually, now that I think about it. Oh, it's in. Oh, she had a little baby. She went down. This is precisely what I wanted it for. You know, she had it in the little underground tunnel area. There's our baby bison. Okay, so I don't love this, but I do like this exhibit. I think they look great in there. Look at him. Oh, it's getting misty as well. Love a bit of mist. It is a shame about this viewing distance thing going on here. Whereas in the opaqueness is different depending on how far away we are from the things. Kind of a pain in the butt, but I can't seem to do anything. I don't see a view distance option in the graphics options, so if there is something I can do about it, I don't know what it is. Where are my other Pronghorns, more importantly? Animal escaped. I find that hard to believe. What are you on about? No, they didn't. You're talking nonsense. Let's make sure everyone's okay. You're still. Are you moving from the Trade Center, or do you live in the Trade Center now, or can we just get them all moved, thank you. One of them is an albino, because it was just happened to be one of the cheapest females on the exhibit. I didn't really plan. Oh, it's raining. I didn't really plan for it, but it's pretty cool. I wonder if the Pronghorns are. Oh, okay. Yep, that's my bad. Come here. See, I did try with the vendors. I just couldn't come up with a shop design that I was happy with. You know, it had to blend in with the rest of the zoo at the end of the day. So I think it's going to have to be a separate thing. How happy. Little Pronghorns. Also, how cute is this? Aww. how happy are the Pronghorns in the snow? Because I imagine not very. They're on the move. Finally, they're on the move. It looks really cool. Yeah, I think we just need more stuff like this. The Ghost of Black Rock. Something over here. I think that area being full of something will brighten and lift the whole area quite a lot anyway. So I'm not that worried about it. I just need to come up with some ideas. Didn't do a single challenge, did I? I haven't done this one either. I've been slacking so much on the community challenges. I literally did not try the panda one. Makes me feel bad. Where's my Pronghorns? Right, they're sitting in the. Yeah, they don't love the snow. But temperature wise, they're okay. Yeah, they're fine with it. And it's just not snowing. There we go. They're all. Oh, and it's snowing again. They're all hanging around having a good time. Admittedly, they are hiding away in the non snowy bits, but that makes a lot of sense because they don't like that terrain. Unknown soldier, thank you for the 20 credits. Your sacrifice for my zoo has been noted. It's a zoo, not a park. It's a zoo, not a park. It's a zoo, not a park. I know, it's a problem. Right, yeah, I'm generally speaking pretty happy. I'm really excited to see what it looks like at night. I think this area in here is going to need some lighting up. I am curious whether we're making money. Let's find out. So, we're on 8,000 at the moment. We're on 7,900 at the moment. Okay, we're definitely not making money yet. 7,800. 7,700. 7,600. 7,500. Okay, I think we can safely say we're not making money, okay? I don't think that's. Oh, I guess. Oh, we just went up to 8,000. I wasn't paying attention. Are we making money? Are we actually making cash? Can I actually hit the play button in my zoo? I think we're making money, ladies and gentlemen. I think bringing in the second animals made a difference. And we can check it out at night time. How's that for a finale? So, Ghost of Blackrock, you wander forward, you carry on. Look at the lighting behind that. I think those look really cool, I've got to say. It's like this... I mean, obviously I've already explained the idea, but to me it kind of keeps looking like a bit of a... like a really like futuristic city as well, like skyscrapers and stuff. I love it though, with the sunset behind it, sunrise, sunset. So this will look really cool. This is quite nice already with the lights hitting the glass and everything, but it just needs something there, like a little bit of a display that can then blend into the walls, and that'll tie that whole bit together. I loved how this, I mean, this doesn't take any skill, but I really like how they look. I want to move that up a little bit, I think. I really like how the metal things look. There, staff only sign looking lovely. And like I said, I want to make those doors more prominent. Let's take a look in here. Definitely need to light that up a little bit. Let's do that right now, tell you what. Why not? We never do any building. Maybe that's what we can do in the future, right? We can do the time lapse during the daytime and most of that stuff. And then at night time, we'll hit play and we'll finish off with a little bit of lighting as well. Something like that. God knows what I'm going to do in here. I'm thinking about the tree sculptures. The problem is the tree sculptures don't actually light the area up at all. They're actually kind of useless. And I'm stuck on the roof. There is actually an option. I found it just the other day. I found the option to make the camera completely free. Like it doesn't get stopped by buildings and stuff. I don't like that. The problem is it then makes your camera really slow for some reason. And I haven't really found out how to not do either. Like it's either really slow and free or it's not. Oh, it's rubbish, basically. Like, I don't know how to fix that. Let's get some lights going. I'll figure out what I'm going to do in there eventually. I'm going to do these about even on both sides. So I can maintain control. That's a little bit too far out. I've got to say, this whole area is been a massive pain. I don't know what it is, but every time I click, it's like it just goes to the wrong item constantly. I think just because of how much stuff is in here, it's causing problems. It's been a pitter. There we go. Perfect. I like doing one side lit up. I like to keep the lights away, especially from the viewing area portion, just because I think lights would kind of blind the view a little bit and you should be able to just see into the exhibit completely. So we'll keep the lights there. That looks pretty cool. I just want to light up the antelope just a little bit. That's all I want. Maybe we can use the spotlight. Now the spotlight, as you're about to see, is intense, but if you move it further away, a little less intense. And the best trick to doing this is actually just set like a dark color like that. There you go. Look at that. Beautiful. Can even hide that under the ground a little bit, I think, without any problems. Don't want to hide it completely, that looks stupid. There we go. Nicely lit up. Sweet. Okay. I'm pretty happy, yeah. I think that staff sign looks really cool for some reason. I think just the colour scheme. I might grab that for somewhere else. Do I not have another staff section? Still need to write the tail down. Thank you for the suggestions, by the way, for the tail. I haven't finished it yet, clearly, but I will. I'm just going to put this on here. It does say staff on the left, but just to make sure, let's put a staff on the sign in there as well. There we go. Look at that. Beautiful. Okay. I actually prefer those signs a lot. I might replace all the signs with those. I'm not sure about these metal ones anymore. Yeah, this area looks really nice. You walk forward. This area isn't quite as nice, but it'll get there when there's something there. Maybe a little bit more detail on this wall. I'm pretty happy. The pronghorns seem pretty happy. I'd like to get a few more in here, but we are near the max population end. You know, a little room for the babies. Never hurt anyone. And there's our albino. M. That is a terrible name. I shall rename you Carbuncle. For reasons I'm unsure. Hello, Carbuncle. Beautiful. It's kind of cute, right? And kind of terrifying at the same time. It's an odd combination. Like a sexy gremlin. Anyways, right, we're going to end it there then. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, one more thing I want to try. One last thing. What does this do? Right, no, that's rubbish. I want to see what happens if we light these up. Even just a little bit. I really want that. I'm thinking the spotlight. And I'm gonna, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rotate it so that it faces straight up. And we're gonna grab one and we're gonna put it in the middle. Okay, that didn't work. Let's just shift that across. This is more difficult than I intended. Maybe I light them up like that. Oh, that might look pretty good. Let's bring that up. I don't know, I feel there should be some lights here somehow, but I'm not quite sure how to do it. Feel free to hit me up in the comments. We could even try... Oh, that's what I want to check. Yeah, I did a thing. Let me see if it's there. I put lights on the solar panel, because lights are cool. I'm thinking we could maybe use those and create like rings around bits of them. You know, maybe just the tops. Light up the tops using these things here. Should we try that? Let's try that as well. Let's just try everything. So I'm just going to light. I'm going to pick one relatively central. Let's go here. Let's grab that. It could look over the top. That's why I'm... Oh, wait. Do you not have power? You're not going to have power. Tell you what. We'll do that in the future. But let me know what you think about that as an idea. Bloody no. This cost a fortune, by the way. Let me know what you think. And we'll try that in the future. Until then, thank you very much for joining me. Cheers. Much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.